Hello, dear friends. 2021 is almost over, and today I wanted to make for you special end of the year shoemaking tutorial.
Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses.
During this year, I made a lot of different shoemaking tutorials, every week tutorial, so maybe you missed one of them. That's why today I collected my top 5 shoemaking tutorials that will be most useful and actionable for your shoemaking craft. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's go! Lasting shoes. This is the process where you finally will see how your shoe will look on the shoe last, and it's a very important step in shoemaking. So there is certain way how to pull upper and lining together working with professional shoemaking tool, and in this tutorial I teach how to last upper and lining together working like a pro. So we need to place it in the way where the center that lays between these two marks, this one and in the middle of the quarters, you will turn it over like this and will last both parts of our upper. And then grab lining and upper together and pull. I was searching for myself and for my students how they can work at home without any industrial machines and make their shoes very fast and easy. So I come up with the idea to use Dremel drill. It's not a traditional shoemaking tool, but this tool, believe me, will help you a lot in your shoemaking craft. So in this tutorial you can see how to work with this tool and what you can do working with this tool. Don't think that it's very easy to work with it. It's easier than skiving, but you also need to know how to work it to not ruin your work, okay? So you need to work very precisely. What is important here is that in some places it will be difficult, for example in this place where we attach the inner surface of the heel to the shoe bottom, it has kind of curve that maybe will be difficult to sand with the rasp. So you can sand with the Dremel drill this area. In the final step of your work, when you will finish making shoes, you need to attach the sock liner. And this inner detail is very important and it will upgrade the look of your shoes. So you need to know how to make the pattern of this detail. And when you will know the classic, the simple pattern of sock liner, you will be able to adjust it according to your design wishes. So in this tutorial you can learn how to make sock liner. We have two most extended places, in front part of the insole and in the back part of the insole. So you can do it by eyes. So here we have most extended place, and in the middle of this most extended place we need to make a point. This is how we reduced the toe part to create pattern for the sock liner, because it must be a little bit shorter and this edge of the sock liner will not bend when we will attach it to the insole and will not bother your toes. Working with wedge sandals, you have variety of design possibilities to create many beautiful sandals. And in this tutorial I show what you can do working with simple wedge heels. Watch this tutorial. To create wedge from cork, for example, and use it in sandals, you have to work with sandals last.
But if you want to create the wedge cork on different shoelace step, you also can do it. Okay, the wedge cork is only the part of design that can be attached, can be used in any shoe type. Okay.
Perforation in shoemaking. This detail can help you a lot to upgrade any footwear type that you will want to create. It was my last tutorial where I show step by step how to create this perforation and how to use it in any footwear type. So make sure to watch this tutorial.
Inside of this basic button, you can use this perforation. So I decided to use this perforation, to make this perforation in the front part. So I divided my flat body shoes on two parts, with the toe cap like this, simple toe cap with a rounded shape.
So what you can use is compasses for pattern making that consists of two pins, two sharp pins. For example, in usual compasses we have one sharp pin and pencil. So for pattern making there is compasses with two pins. Thank you for watching this tutorial and for watching all my tutorials. I'm sending you all my love. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you again and see you in the new year. Bye.